PhenoMx is applying precision medicine techniques to the annual physical exam, but you're hoping this will have global healthcare implications as well as enhancing personalized well-being.
Yes, absolutely. Let's say you get a digital exam as a component of your annual physical this year, next year, and the next, and we can track where you're changing. But since we have global experience setting up, let's say, 500 sites for some of the largest pharma in the world, we would like to be able to transition this type of technology, platform, and capabilities to something that will be beneficial for global population health. Right now, maybe the cardiologist looks at 5 or 10 values from the electronic medical record. Maybe the hepatologist or gastroenterologist looks at 5 or 10 measurements of the liver. They do not necessarily communicate to each other, but for us, if we're getting 300 variables and 500 variables, the data science will help us separate out and see trends. So once we get that down, I think the opportunity to collaborate on a larger scale leads to a tremendous amount of more insight.
Who are you collaborating with in order to achieve this?
So we're starting off with a few key opinion leaders in the academic arena to enhance our opportunity to provide the publications, research, and scientific validations that are beneficial, especially in this day and age of digital health startups and things like that. As a health tech company, we are not just focused on being traditional diagnostic and med tech and being siloed off, proprietary, looking to sell some technology. We're actually very integrative and collaborative in our approach, where I'm looking at the interaction of the organs. So when you mentioned multiple data sets from sensors and digital health, we would certainly love to partner. And we're looking at projects right now in Asia that are not just early adoption, but early implementation, where there are platforms being built, hundreds, if not thousands of hospitals to be connected, to collect all of these multi-omic data, the genomics, the blood work, the imaging, and make sense of it all.
Access to MRIs is limited though. Is this a challenge you're working on?
We are looking at some new technologies, whether academic or private developed, for a portable MRI system that could be deployed in remote regions, whether it's desert, jungle, or mountain. And with the advancing of automation, looking at the opportunity to say, acquire the images, without as much expertise on the ground, and then transferred and processed by the software and platform that we're developing now to provide an end-to-end automation system to quantify these major organs and tissues of the whole body. But again, instead of being N of one and for our individual benefit, we would like to see it be for the global population health.
So how do you see PhenoMx changing the future of health?
So we're starting with imaging as a service, so that we can enhance the annual physical. And I would say in the 1 to 2, maybe 3 year time frame, all of the other technologies that are out there, digital health, sensors, remote monitoring, that is also progressing, we will still be able to validate them, combine and collaborate with them to provide an experience that perhaps you don't need to see your doctor. Perhaps you can get continuously measured at home and then go to an imaging facility that we've trained and ensured the quality control on, one of our centers of excellence, such that we then combine these two remote measurements on your own terms, on your own time and scheduling, not from having to go see a doctor and then making another appointment in 2 weeks, to be something that you can then consult with your physician or be alerted that something is going to happen or you should take action, perhaps the system then becomes prompting and engaging of you. Now, the trajectory becomes what more will be done? What will change as we begin to say, catch diseases earlier? Can we alter the course of what you might do? Whether it's your eating, smoking, exercise, where you live, some of the other environmental conditions that are not related to your genomics, or the internal workings of your body. Those social determinants of health are other aspects that are starting to come into play much more along with the focus on the patient.
Mark, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
This was the second half of our interview with Mark Punyanitya. Click to watch the first half of our conversation now. Learn more at phenomx.co. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe for more disruptive innovations and transformative insights from theneweconomy.com.